In recent days, there were big news in the media of the Chinese spy ship named Yuan Wang 5 anchoring in Hambantota port in Sri Lanka. India and the US raised concern on the ship's capabilities and declared it posed a security threat. But nowhere has India nor the US clearly mentioned what is the exact nature of threat it poses. India says this Chinese ship can track India's naval assets. But what is that this ship can do that cannot be done using satellites in space? In this video, we will analyze exactly how the spy ship poses a threat to India's security. Intelligence is an important part of warfare, and spy ships have played an important role in intelligence gathering. After the arrival of satellite technology, it has become rather confusing as to what exactly is the secret information that these spy ships gather. Spy ships came into prominence during the Cold War. Spy ships were used to track enemy communications, fleet movements, and detect nuclear tests. But these things can be tracked from space also. But one of the most important functions of a spy ship is that it tracks submarine signatures. This is the noise that the submarine makes and can be used to identify it. This is something that cannot be done from space. During the Cold War, the US fielded 80 ships to track Soviet submarines. These ships were disguised and were called environmental research crafts. In response, the Soviets fielded almost 60 spy ships disguised as fishing trawlers. During the 1960s, the US started deployment of ballistic missile submarines. The Soviets wanted to track these subs along with their UGM-27 Polaris ballistic missiles. Coming back to the Indian scenario, India has around 15 conventional attack submarines purchased from Germany, Russia, and France. Of these, the Russian-made kilo-class subs are the oldest. Also, there is one nuclear attack submarine called INS Chakra 2 and one indigenously built ballistic missile submarine, INS Arihant. Very little is known about INS Arihant. This submarine is indigenous and even a proper image of this submarine is not available. Also, the Indian Navy has launched a massive upgradation program to its older Soviet-era kilo-class attack submarines. Details are not revealed. In November 2021, CBI filed two charge sheets against a dozen serving and retired naval officers and some others for allegedly sharing details of the ongoing modernization program of the India's kilo-class submarines. Submarines are the backbone of the naval warfare, as they cannot be detected so easily. Also, it is the most survivable leg of the nuclear triad. As relations between India and China heats up, it was obvious both countries would need a deeper understanding of each other's naval capabilities. China has the largest navy in the world, with a total of 350 ships. Of this, China has 50 conventional and around 20 nuclear submarines. The Chinese navy operates more than 4,000 kilometers from the nearest Indian shore. The only way for China to monitor the Indian Navy would be to send spy ships through the Malacca Strait to the Arabian Sea, Bay of Bengal, and the Indian Ocean. For such a long voyage, a replenishment and supply base is required. The Hambantota base in Sri Lanka is an apt location for this. The Chinese Navy had taken over this deep water port on lease for 99 years after Sri Lanka defaulted on its loan payment given by China for the port's construction. China has converted the deep water Hambantota port for docking both its civilian and naval vessels. The Hambantota port is strategic because it is in the middle of a busy shipping port between Malacca Strait and Suez Canal. An estimated 36,000 ships, including 4,500 oil tankers, use the route annually. The port was first offered to India, but India did not foresee the strategic importance of this port first. Only after the Chinese came are Indians raising objections. India had helped Sri Lanka many times, but it does not have a strategic or a military relationship with the island country. India has naval assets located at Mumbai, Cochin, Vizag, and Andaman Nicobar Islands. The spy ship sent by China recently is named Yuan Wang 5. It is China's third-generation research vessel fitted with advanced equipment. It's a large ship with a displacement of 25,000 tons and 470 crew members. It is designed to track satellites, ICBMs, and also capture submarine signatures. So what will this spy ship actually do? India does not have a blue water navy, hence its ships operate close to the Indian shores. Yuan Wang 5 would stay in the international waters and would use its electronic equipment to listen into the radar and radio frequencies of the Indian Navy and Air Force. The ship has a surveillance capacity of 750 kilometers. It would then try to intercept and decrypt coded radio and phone communications. This is mostly done via passive means such as radio receivers or passive sonar. India tests its latest long-range missiles from Wheeler Island in Odisha. This can be an apt place for the Chinese to learn about India's newest military capabilities. Almost all the Indian secret military and civilian assets will come under its surveillance range. The spy ship can easily cover the 6 Indian ports and 2 civilian nuclear facilities. China is today a big military power, but in spite of its size, the Chinese military has an Achilles heel. China imports 80% of its fuel. Fuel is a lifeline of any country. Chinese oil imports travel through the busy Malacca Straits. If a war breaks out, the easiest way to drain China is to impose a naval blockade of the Malacca Straits. Hence, the Chinese want to secure their supply route. China has already operationalized the Gwadar port in Karachi and Hambantota ports for both military and civilian use. These bases will be used for resupplying ships operating in the Indian Ocean. While China is out there securing its supplies and projecting itself as a world power, India will now have to revamp its Indian Ocean strategy. From being a purely defense-oriented navy, India should take steps to develop a blue water navy and be in a position to take any Chinese threat. If you like this video, please subscribe for more. Thanks for watching.